Yo, what is going on, Guardians? Mikowski here, and in today's video, we're going to be talking about the future of Keektar Nation community tournaments. Something very near and dear to my heart, something that we started back in November of last year. We're coming up on a full year of running tournaments, and it's been an absolute blast, and I'm excited to share some of the plans that we have in place for the future. Now, if you don't know what I'm saying, what is a Keektar? What is this? Let me break it down for you. Each month, we host open draft tournaments that anybody can participate in. And that's probably, for me, the most important thing that we maintain going forward. I want everyone, whether they're an MLG sweatlord or a total noob, to feel like this is something they can get involved in and be excited about. I know for a lot of people, these tournaments were some of their first ever experiences competing, and that's something that I'm super proud of. Competing is something very near and dear to my heart. It's something I've been doing all the way back since the early 2000s with the MLG Pro Circuit in Halo, and the fact that these tournaments have been an opportunity to introduce new gamers and new Guardians to the thrill of competitive, whatever it is, Call of Duty, Destiny, Halo, Counter-Strike, it's all awesome. Right? And a lot of people have got to experience that for the first time because of these tournaments, and that's pretty freaking awesome. So once a month, we pull together a group of Guardians that are entered into a draft, and the day before the tournament, they're drafted by one of eight captains. Usually, captains are exceptional PvP players, or one of your favorite content creators, or maybe even both, like Ceridius, Frostbolt, Panda, or even an up-and-coming talent like my boy, Onyxly, who have all competed in and or won some of these tournaments. Which is really cool because it allows anyone to get a chance to play with their favorite players. And so I've really liked this approach because it has the Fortnite Friday feel of bringing in well-known talent from the community while still letting anyone participate. Because you need big names, like the ones I mentioned, to draw interest and viewership, right? But community involvement is typically limited to just watching these types of things. I love what we've built because it allows new players to participate, get involved, and ultimately grow the scene. I know from gathering feedback from the Destiny community that one of the top reasons for not playing and getting more involved in these tournaments is because they don't have a set team. The draft formula is the perfect way to get everyone involved, whether you're a veteran or a total rookie, which I think is one of the most important tasks facing the Destiny 2 tournament scene, is just simply getting more people involved. Over the past almost year now, I think we've done an amazing job of doing just that. Like I said, in November, we'll have been running tournaments for an entire year. And along the way, we've learned a lot, from something as simple as starting on time to introducing one of the largest prize pools in Destiny's history when we hosted a $5,000 tournament featuring the biggest players in the game, all playing alongside other Guardians in the community. Which I have to stop down for a second and give a huge thanks to the ultimate homie, Kenny Vaccaro, for making all of this even possible. Now, if you guys didn't know, Kenny plays safety for the Tennessee Titans, and he's also the biggest Destiny fan I know. I've seriously never met a bigger gamer, in the truest sense of it, in my life than what I've gotten to know and love about Kenny since we became friends and started hosting these tournaments together over the past year. Also, a huge shout out to our tournament admins, Flexify and Clutch. It wouldn't be possible without these guys, so I just wanted to stop down for a second and say thanks. Now, with growth comes change, and with that, I'm excited to announce a fairly big change in our community tournaments. Moving forward, we will no longer play 4v4 mixed games like Clash, Control, and Survival. Instead, we will be shifting focus to 3v3 instead. Now, this decision was made after Bungie's This Week at Bungie, where they announced 3v3 elimination and a return to the 3v3 formula, which I know the sweat community has been running with great success lately. And I just think it's time to embrace 3v3 in an effort to work together, look towards the future, and try to be on the same page. Because at the end of the day, we all share the same goal to grow the scene and make it something huge, even if we have different approaches to how we get there, which is why we'll also officially be adopting the Destiny 2 tournament rules as well. Like with Halo in 2009, the right tweaks and adjustments to the sandbox can make games like Destiny really shine as being a top-tier pinnacle arena shooter. And I think the Destiny 2 tournament community has done a really good job with that in making competitive Destiny fair, fun, and balanced. Which, as we all know, with the changes coming in Shadowkeep, such as supers, holy crap, I expect the PvP experience to really shine in the tournament environment. Now, I know I stressed player participation earlier in this video, and you're probably wondering, but wait, Mikowski, by moving to threes, doesn't that mean less Guardians will get to experience the thrill and joy of competitive Destiny? Well, you are right, Guardian, and that's why we're expanding the pool of teams from 8 to 16. In addition to these changes, we will also be using Battlefy so people can more easily check brackets, update matches, see who's on which team, and more. Now, you're probably also asking yourself, Mikowski, when will we get to experience these incredible changes in action? This will all be implemented in our next tournament, which will be Saturday, September 14th, Guardian. Mark your calendars! The next Keektar Nation Community Tournament featuring some of these sweeping changes is just a few weeks away. Now, this wouldn't really be a proper announcement video without some really big news. With that being said, I'm excited to announce that in October, the weekend after Shadowkeep launches, we will be hosting a $3,000 3v3 tournament. Mark your calendar, Guardian, for October 5th. That's when it'll all go down. Again, a huge thanks to Kenny Vaccaro for sponsoring this tournament and really putting on for the Destiny community, man. We don't know how lucky we are to have a guy like Kenny. And I love you, bro. I appreciate you, man. Thank you for making all this possible, dude. I'm hyped. Y'all, please, to show your appreciation, drop a follow on my man's Twitch and Instagram, which we'll put in the description below, and check out some of his Destiny content. The dude's actually a fragger, dude. Like incredible football player, absolute fragger, and totally awesome, dude. Please check out and support my friend, Kenny Vaccaro. And again, thank you for making all this possible. And lastly, in closing this video out, I just wanted to address a tweet I sent out, which seemed to offend some people in the tourney community. In it, I suggested finding a new name for the tournament scene, which, looking back on, I can see why it upset so many people. And I get it. It seemed like I was challenging everything you had come to know and loved about the tournament scene. And that just simply wasn't what I was trying to accomplish. I want to help grow the tournament scene. I want to get more people involved. I've competed on the MLG main stage before in front of hundreds and thousands of viewers. I've been sponsored by big companies like Toyota and represented their brands in the public eye. And I want to help you accomplish those same things too, because I truly believe there are some incredible personalities in the tournament scene that don't get the love and recognition they deserve. And I really do believe that with the right approach, we could get this thing into something where it gets big enough, where we have MLG main stages and sponsors and $100,000, million-dollar tournaments. And if we don't, that's fine. But at least we tried. At least we had fun. At least we brought everyone together over our shared passion for competitive Destiny. If that's all we do, then that's a success. But like I said, I really think we can go to the next level and turn this into something where it's as big as something on the MLG Pro Circuit. So my DMs are open. I have most of you guys added on Destiny and Twitter and all that stuff. So please reach out if you guys ever want to talk about anything. I want to work with you guys. I want to grow the scene with you guys. And I think that our tournaments could actually be like this breeding ground for talent that ultimately ends up winning some of these huge tournaments that you guys are throwing in the future. I definitely think that we're both onto something here with these tournaments, and why not work together to make it even bigger than it already is? Thank you guys so much for tuning into this video. Hope you guys are excited about the changes coming to the community tournaments. Let me know what you think in the comment section below. We got a lot of awesome news in this video. I want to know what you guys think. If you guys want to get involved in these tournaments, make sure you join the Discord in the description below. That's where we all organize and get together for these tournaments. Leave a like. Make sure you're subscribed to the channel. As always, stay positive, keep sniping, and we'll see you in orbit, Guardian.